because this man, Psycho Sid, is quite an imposing figure.
He is an awesome individual, and what makes him extremely dangerous, besides the obvious physical condition of the man, is that he is out there. You look at his eyes, you wonder what makes him tick, what makes that heart beat. You know, some of it's about money because he's joined up in the ranks of Ted DiBiase at the Million Dollar Corporation, but what drives this man? He is out there.
Psycho Sid and the Million Dollar Man, no doubt, will be lurking about on Raw this week when King Kong Bundy takes on the returning Shawn Michaels. It was that man, Psycho Sid, who was in cahoots, shall we say. He was associated with Ted DiBiase all along. DiBiase, with all his subterfuge, set the plot in motion. He tricked Shawn Michaels into retaining Psycho Sid as Shawn's bodyguard. The rest is history. That man almost put Shawn Michaels out of commission for good.
Bob Holly has been on a roll in the World Wrestling Federation, almost capturing the Intercontinental Championship a couple of weeks ago here in the Action Zone against Double J Jeff Jarrett. What do you think he's going to have to do against a man the size of Sid? Maybe I don't have to answer that.
Well, Bob Holly will not be intimidated. He is a fighter, no doubt about it. But Tony's got to use his quickness and speed to survive here. Holly, cross body.
Oh.
He got him down first. Holly draws the first hot iron here as his Psycho Sid back up to his vertical base, and he's drop kicked right back outside by Bob Spark Plug Holly, and Psycho Sid is irate.
Look at Ted DiBiase just looking at Sid. Hey, he wants him to get back in there. Look, even DiBiase's afraid of Sid. You see him looking at him? You don't know what this guy's going to do.
Sid now trying to manhandle Bob Spark Plug Holly. Right hands to the body. Boy, those are Tyson-like right hands.
He is
and
awesome.
Listen to the chant. Diesel, Diesel. They're chanting, we want Diesel.
Hard clothesline there.
And he is a very physical force here in the WWF. And with Tatanka, would make a phenomenal tag team combination.
No question about it. You think he's hearing voices right now? You see the way he just looks out into space?
I think he watched too much of the Twilight Zone when he was a kid.
The light's on, but I don't know if there's anybody home.
Bob Holly has been knocked to his knees now several times by Psycho Sid. And this is exactly what Bob Holly did not want to happen.
Don't let him catch you calling him Psycho. He doesn't like to be called Psycho Sid.
That's what we hear. And look at that running kick right to the head. And this is a vicious competitor.
Bob Holly really got to be hurting after that.
Well, Bob Holly is a great athlete. And as you mentioned, former tag team champion here in the WWF, he will fight you. He will not back away from anybody, but you can't fight Sid and win. You got to wrestle him. You got to get him off his feet to be successful.
No question. If you try to match power with Sid, he'll make you pay. Look.
That Sid with that wide base.
And Bob Holly quickly jumps out of the way of that one.
And now Holly's got him down. Got him rolled up, but only got a one count out of it. Holly going to the far side. Coming, and that's great flexibility for a guy that's just under 7 feet tall.
That big boot of Sid, and look at him just stare at the audience.
You know,
I don't even know if he knows where he is.
I think he wears a size 16 boot.
You're kidding.
Huge man. And I'll tell you something, his rivalry with Diesel obviously has not subsided. It's only escalated. And these guys are going to meet somewhere down the road. And I'm not so sure what it's going to take to settle their one-on-one issue. It may be a steel cage. It's got to be something special because it's going to be for the WWF title.
Look at the height on that leg drop.
That's great athletic gifts. I mean, you know, I don't like the guy personally. His philosophy and the way he treats people, he talks to people, you know, his whole psychotic is not, you know, my cup of tea.
Well, he's got some sort of complex, but you can't take anything away from his ring ability because inside that squared circle, he is awesome.
Watch him now. He's relentless as he gains the advantage. When he has the advantage, when he is able to be on the offensive, he is as deadly and as dangerous as anyone who has ever competed in the WWF. But let's face it, I don't think the guy, you know, he doesn't like to be on the defensive at all. He's not a tremendous counter wrestler. He likes to dish it out, come at you. He doesn't like to have a fist in his face. We saw what happened at In Your House.
Look at that. How much more can Bob Holly take? Listen, you hear that? I am the ruler of the world, he said.
Well, those kicks right to the ribs certainly have done a lot of damage as Bob Holly.
Now, wait a minute. Here comes Tatanka.
Well, what do they need Tatanka out here for?
See, that's what. You face one member of that million-dollar corporation, you got to believe in the back of your mind, you're facing all of them.
Well, and that's exactly what Shawn Michaels has to contend with when he faces King Kong Bundy on Raw this week in that King of the Ring qualifying matchup. You never know how many are going to be out there.
Ted DiBiase throws around that money. Tatanka's there. Who knows?
Diesel coming to the front here. And again, Sid, that big size 16 boot right to the side of the head of Bob Spark Plug Holly.
Really incredible the amount of resiliency being shown by Bob Holly to be able to withstand this kind of punishment.
You know, when Diesel suffered at the hands, look at that, at the hands of Psycho Sid in Sid's powerbomb, I thought it was over. At that point, the referee counted one, two, and Diesel kicked out.
That's right. Look
on Sid's face, as we saw, was total shock. He couldn't believe it, and quite frankly, neither could I.
That may be the only individual in the World Wrestling Federation that can match Sid power for power.
I think you make a very valid point, Todd. But this, like I said, this war is not over, and it's not over here either. Oh, what a right hand. Right in those injured ribs of Bob Spark Plug Holly by Psycho Sid, and that kick right to the sternum. This is a very angry, very sadistic human being.
Unbelievable.
And tremendous power. Bob Holly just driven down over the top ring rope, and look at DiBiase verbally taunting Bob Holly.
Like I said, you face one member of that million-dollar corporation, you got to believe you're facing them all. Tatanka there, DiBiase screaming at Bob Holly. Listen to him.
Well, you know, we talked about this earlier. We both think it's an inevitable situation that someplace Tatanka and Psycho Sid will indeed meet the WWF champion Diesel and Bam Bam Bigelow. And folks, I'll guarantee you, that match will not be pretty. That will not be scientific catch as catch can.
How about that? Telling Big Daddy Cool Diesel, if you want it, come get it.
Well, he'll come get it all right. As we said, that rematch has been signed. Diesel, they chant. And Diesel, they will get when Psycho Sid and Diesel meet for the WWF title. As Bob Spark Plug Holly is gallantly trying to hang on here. But since Psycho Sid gained the momentum, since he slowed it down, it has all been that monster. Look at that face. The face of a bully. And he hesitated. Holly was able to look up and move out of the way.
Incredible the quickness that Bob Holly still has after Sid has really, really been an offensive machine in this match. But Holly's fighting back.
Well, we saw Holly with that upset victory over Mantar to advance to the King of the Ring tournament. He is a tremendous athlete. And he's given it all he's got right here. But he can't seem to take this big monster off his feet. And he get there. He got him one. But only a one count.
Sid is just too big to wrap up that quick. And again, the boot is up and right in the midsection of Bob Holly.
Psycho Sid side headlock takeover. And Holly, what a move. What a tremendous move there. That nip up by Psycho Sid and a choke slam.
Oh, man.
Man, that is athleticism.
Did you see Sid spring to his feet from his back? 7 feet tall.
That is an amazing athletic feat for a man his size.
And Bob Holly at the receiving end of that offensive threat. Boy, just an awesome maneuver.
Uh-oh.
And he's getting ready for the power bomb.
Here comes a power bomb. Here's what he hit Diesel with. He's hit them all with it. And they've all stayed down. But Big Daddy Cool. 1, 2, 3, it's over.
Bob Holly putting up a great effort. But Sid just proved to be too much. And maybe too much for a lot of competitors in the World Wrestling Federation.
Man, let's go back and take a look. We've got to see this again, ladies and gentlemen. Take a look at this. Look at this agility. Tremendous athleticism.
And from his back, up and then the power bomb, down. And that was all she wrote for Bob Holly.
WWF champion. We'll be back.